Even a fast translation program will take 8, 10, 12 years, the fastest ones in Papua New Guinea. More average is 15 to 20 years. There's some that have taken 30 or more years, and we're probably going to be in that category.
This is a language that hasn't been printed. It's not something that you can just take a dictionary and say the Nali word is this and the English word is that, and we'll just substitute a Nali word into an English word. You can't do that. It's very tedious. It's difficult. It's involved. As people are translating the scriptures into Nali, they're also trying to define what is the word and how do you spell it.
Some language groups get so small that they die out. We lose that diversity and that ability to study those languages. It's kind of like when a species biologically dies out, we've lost something. Same efforts ought to be made to preserve some of the languages which are unique in the world.
You go with a long time. Come up long enough, are you looking? 3 days, come. Tomorrow, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and by looking, come up long.
Coronavirus. I want so much for the books to come in time for the dedication. Sometimes I'm almost afraid to download and see what the printer said because I'm afraid I'm going to be devastated by bad news.
Delay come long rain today, delay come long coronavirus, but God in on long stop. Now you're not going to lose anything, so you will all get out.
Hey! My word can never talk. Everything will pass away, but your word will remain.
Why spend all this time translating the Bible for those people who don't have that many speakers of the language? I think they're still deserving of knowing God's word and having God communicate directly to them in the language that speaks to their heart.